Hey, my name is Dr. Sean Price, Clinical Coordinator here at The Fix in Fort Walton, and I wanted to add another video to the section that I did on the mindset. And this is so this is actually going to be mindset number 5. I'm going to put this up here, number 5. And I put wash your truck. So what does that mean? Well, I was listening to a podcast, it was actually a real estate podcast, and a gentleman was talking about a process of he wanted to sell his truck, and he had a loan on his truck. Let's say he owed $7,000 on his truck, and he did not know how to sell a truck that he owed money on and how that would work out. You know, how do you do that? He didn't understand how to do that, and he wanted to do it on his own. He didn't want to trade it in. He wanted to sell it and get as much money as he could for it. So he's thinking, and he's like, how in the world am I going to do this? How do I end up selling this truck? What is my page 40, which will make sense in just a minute, of getting that truck sold? So he started thinking about it. He's like, well, he goes, the one thing I do know how to do right now is I know how to wash my truck. And I can wax it, and I can vacuum it, and I can clean it out. So he goes outside, and he washes his truck, and he waxes it, and he vacuums it, and cleans it out. He's like, okay, what's the next thing that I can figure out how to do? Well, you know, I can put an ad on Craigslist. You know, it's not going to cost me anything, and we'll just see what happens. So he puts an ad on Craigslist. That's his page 2. Then he gets a phone call from a gentleman who wants to come by and look at it. He's like, okay. He goes, well, I can show my truck, it's clean, it looks good. I can show my truck, there's no risk in that. And, you know, we'll see what happens. So he does that. The gentleman that comes and looks at the truck and wants to buy the truck. So then he goes through this process, and step by step, he figures out what's the next step. What's the next step? How do I do this? And eventually he gets to the point where he sold his truck. Okay, but it started off with something as simple as, what do I know how to do? How do I do this? So if you're in a situation where you're trying to get healthy, and you maybe see somebody who's been leading a healthy lifestyle for years, and they're at their ideal body weight, and they have a lot of passion and a lot of energy, and they're living their lives, and they're, you know, making good income, and they have a healthy, happy family life, and they've got all these things that they've done. And you're in a place where maybe your family life isn't great because you don't have the energy to play with your kids, and you don't have the energy to exercise, and, you know, you're not eating very well, and all these different things. You're comparing yourself, your page 1, to their page 40. And you cannot do that because that gets very overwhelming. You can't look at somebody who's been doing something for a period of time and see what they've accomplished and see what they're able to do and then judge where you are based on that, because you don't know what it took for them to get there. People see business people all the time who are quote unquote overnight successes because all of a sudden they've got this huge successful business. Well, they didn't see the 10, 20, 30 years of struggle, of hard work, of, you know, 18-hour days that went into that process. Patients see us at the clinic, myself and the other doctors, as being doctors, and we have this great professional career, and we do. We are so fortunate for what we have. But what you don't see is the $200,000 in student loan debt that we have, the 8 years of college that we had to go through, the sacrifices of how do you raise a family while you're going through college, all the things that we had to go through to get to the point where we are. In a healthy person, again, somebody who's achieved great health, you haven't seen what they've done through to get to that point. So you have to start on your page 1. What is your page 1? What are you going to do today? What are you going to do today that's going to put you on the path to get you moving in the right direction? What do you know that you can do today? Maybe it's calling our office and making an appointment for the initial exam and consult. Maybe it's going to your pantry and throwing away that food, that favorite junk food that you have, and you throw that away. And then tomorrow you'll wake up and you'll be like, what can I do today? Maybe it's coming in for your second visit to get your report of findings with us. Maybe it's going for a 5-minute walk around the block. What's your page 3? Page 3 could be you start treatment with us, or maybe it's that you decide to eat a little bit better and you decide, you know what, for breakfast I'm gonna eat a certain thing. Or maybe your page 1 is you decide to go to our website and watch all of our thyroid videos so you understand what you're doing. Whatever it is, do something today. Start today with an action, because when you do that, you begin that book. And eventually you're gonna get to your page 40. And when you get to your page 40, you're going to see, okay, what's next for page 41? Remember, we talked about what's your potential, what's your big why. Just because you got to page 40 doesn't mean you're done. Now you can see what's next, what's possible. Because once you get here and you see what this reality is, you are now able to see and understand what's possible beyond that. Right now, all you can see is what's possible beyond today. So focus on today. Focus on what you're going to do today. Focus on what can you do that gets you started in the right direction. Go out and wash your truck. Go out and do something today to help you move towards your goals. Okay, I hope that makes sense. Let me know if you have any questions.